Hi, my name is Mark, and I'm here to show you how Zebra BI can help you unlock new insights from your reports. Whether you're a seasoned pro or a newcomer to the world of Power BI, our quick tour will help you harness the full potential of your data. So let's get started. Starting on the landing page of the sales report, we have a cards visual that shows how we are performing with our top KPIs. Then we have a chart that shows trends and how we performed on each month. Below them are two tables showing the main breakdowns by business unit and product categories. Remember, tables are for showing structural breakdowns and charts mainly used for showing time trends. As you can see, red color is showing negative variances and green is used for positive variances. This allows you to instantly understand how you are doing across individual elements. Besides easy color coding, we also have IBCS abbreviations. So AC stands for actual data, PL stands for plan, PY for previous year, and FC stands for forecast. Okay, so our landing page gives us a nice quick overview of how we're doing overall. But now let's say we're interested in what's happening with costs or gross profit. You simply click on that element and it will filter the rest of the page. And while we're at it, when starting out, you should try to click on everything. Just click on all the possible elements here to see how the interactions work, right? And don't worry, because you won't break anything, as you can always return to the original state of the report, because if you changed anything, such as the variance display here, a reset button will appear that will revert the report back to the original state. Now that we know we won't break anything in the report, let's continue with our interaction options. First, we can use the slicers at the top to filter our data. We can also switch between monthly and year-to-date numbers directly on the dashboard. Within Zebra BI Visuals, you have several ways of viewing the data as well. So we can use the chart slider, which appears on mouse hover, to switch between different views in both the charts and the tables themselves. In the table columns, you can choose what kind of visualization you want to include. Maybe you wish to see more than just numbers, even in this view. Simply go to the column drop down here for the previous year variance and select the desired chart. So we can switch to a plus and minus chart or a waterfall chart if you wish to see the contribution to the total. Exploring the insights themselves is easy. If we want to understand our gross profit underperformance, we should probably filter that page by clicking on that KPI. Analyzing the breakdowns in the tables, we can easily increase or decrease the number of elements by clicking on the arrows next to the others row, which combines all the smaller categories into one. We see that the mobile unit is giving us problems, and so naturally, we might want to see a further breakdown of how we are doing by some other category, for instance, countries. We can easily hover over the data point, and a report page tooltip with a nice condensed waterfall chart showing the contribution of each country will appear. We see that it's not just one region that is problematic, so we should probably try to learn more before making any decision. We can dive deeper into this issue in three ways. We can either drill through into the gross profit itself by using the cards drill through button here, or we can click on the mobile group by holding down Control, and this then cross-filters the page with gross profit still selected. By doing this, we should understand how our selections correlate to the rest of the landing page, and then we can use the drill through button if we still need more information. Now, clicking on the drill through button takes us to the detailed page where we have more information on our performance. And once we get the insights we need for taking action, we can easily move back to our landing page by clicking on the back button. The same back and forth from overview to details can be done with overlay buttons. So if you want to know everything about business units, for instance, click on the top button. You can then use the top-level menu to explore different aspects of the details, such as month-to-date and year-to-date comparisons, show all KPIs, display trends. And once you know everything that you need to know, you can always move back to the homepage. This is the easiest and most efficient way of using dashboards to get actionable insights. I hope you enjoyed this brief overview of interacting with the Zebra BI report. However, this was just the tip of the iceberg of actionable reporting. If you want to know more, visit our website at zebrabi.com, and until next time, see you.